walk around like that bitch. I walk around like that bitch.
Huh? What? I thought a bro said something. Talk with, but they still ain't saying nothing. We gon' trap this down till the feds come.
Run it up, run it up.
Huh?
What she say?
I thought a said something. I go when I'm talking, you listen.
Just listen.
Cut her off cause she spoke on the business.
Go.
Now on to eyebrows. So with my eyebrows, I actually started off doing my eyebrows with pencil. I started off doing with like pencils and stuff like that that I would get from like the beauty supply that look like this and stuff. I started off doing my eyebrows with like the Ruby Kisses and like the little random brands of pencils and stuff like that you can get the beauty supply. I definitely recommend those, like the little micro pencils, way more than an actual like pencil, because like with the pencils that you can find and stuff like that, the beauty supply, those will make like your skin like make your eyebrows really oily throughout the day that I've noticed when I was using it. But I can say with this, it also gives you like a natural, a more natural outcome too with the micro pencils to give you like creamy consistency once you put it on your eyebrow. And so then I went to, the more I progress with my eyebrows, I start using the Anastasia Beverly Hills eyebrow pomade. And so, look at this, there's nothing here. And so, I use this like every now and then if I'm just looking for like a real makeup like beat base. But I really don't really use it that much anymore because I don't know, I just be wanting my eyebrows to look like super like natural now. So what I use now is actually dark brown eyeshadow. Like literally, this is eyeshadow. Crazy, right? And so in my guide, my beginner's guide, I have one of the titles, I think it's like number 3. No, it's not like number 4. It should be like, yeah, number 4 for the backwards eyebrow. That will be showing how to do the backwards eyebrow, because not only did I use eyeshadow, but I do my eyebrows a certain way, but not the traditional way. That's all I'm gonna say. You're just gonna have to watch the video to see. But yes, so I actually use dark brown eyeshadow to do my eyebrows now for like a really simple natural look. But if I am going for like a more beat based look, I would go with the pomade. And so yes, that's all I have to say about that. Now lashes. Okay. So with lashes, y'all, literally go to the beauty supply. I buy lashes and stuff like that from like people or like different like Instagram boutiques and stuff like that. But like, it's okay to like go to the beauty supply. I still like got beauty supply. Shoot, I got beauty supply lashes on right now, y'all. I swear to God, I do. And so yeah, like get your lashes from the beauty supply. Literally, y'all, like we do not discriminate. Okay, so for eyeshadow, now y'all, this is the palettes I got. So y'all, for beginners eyeshadow, literally I used to just get like random eyeshadows and stuff like that from like everywhere, like, because everyone, this is a James Charles palette, because like everywhere got like eyeshadow, so I used to always get like random palettes and stuff from like everywhere. So like literally, like just for like beginners eyeshadow, just start off with anything. Like you don't really have to have a name brand, but if you want me to recommend you one, I would definitely recommend Juvia's Palace. I want to call it a palace so bad, but Juvia's Place eyeshadows are all super pigmented and like just super gorgeous. Yes, I know it's gone, don't talk about it, but yes, I definitely would recommend any Juvia's Place palette. This is the 35T Morphe brush palette. I also have the Morphe 35G palette. Looks like this. Oh, I love this palette. I always use like golds and browns in my eyeshadow, so like, yeah, definitely would recommend that. If you're like more of a golds and burnt oranges, stuff like that, it'd be more like a natural nudes and browns and purples and stuff like that. I would recommend the 35O, I think, and Morphe. I love Morphe palettes because they also really good for pigmentation as well. I also have the Anastasia Beverly Hills Subculture palette. I rarely ever use it. Yes, y'all, something just fell. And that's why. But oh my god, I just gotta clean that up later. And so y'all, lips. So for lip gloss, y'all, this is not everything. This is just the stuff I can fit on here. But for lip glosses and lipsticks, I start off with lipsticks like from the Beauty Supply and like Walmart and stuff like that. Oh, I love this red. Milani, don't sleep on Milani, y'all, okay? And just like different lip glosses and stuff like that. So I still get lip glosses from like any place. If it's cute and popping, I'm gonna put it on my lips, period. And so yeah, but a good name brand lip gloss, I would say Sephora's actual makeup brand, Anastasia Beverly Hills. I think I have, I don't know where it's at. Oh, y'all, my favorite. It's NYX. This is what I recommend. NYX butter, what is it? Butter gloss, best ever in the whole entire world. And yes, highly 10 out of 10 recommend that. Best lip gloss ever. And so yes, y'all, that is like all of my makeup, I think. And so yes, like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for the rest of this video and my ultimate beginner's makeup guide. And my ultimate beginner's makeup guide. So yeah, bye. I would start off with primer. I would start off with primers like Maybelline and like e.l.f. and stuff like that. So I got these primers at like my local Beauty Supply or like Walmart and stuff like that. And I really didn't know what I needed at a primer. I just know I needed like minimum coverage. And like, okay, so what I mean by that is like different primers have different like strength levels. So this primer might be like a minimum coverage primer, and then one might be a really thick consistency primer to where it needs to cover like a lot. And so when I started off getting primers, the primers I would get was like fully coverage. And so like I really didn't need that much coverage, you know, I just need like a minimum coverage type of primer. So like my makeup would always turn out like a little cakier than more, because I really didn't need that much primer, like that much of a consistency out of a primer. And so the primers I would get from the Beauty Supply would never really work for me, because I mean, yeah, the coverage was just too thick. And so this primer, the primer I use now, is the Professional primer. And it's like my favorite primer. It's like really lightweight, minimum coverage. And so minimum coverage means like if you don't really have like deep pores and stuff like that, and you just need like a little primer for like a good base, that's the best primer. And I got this for like $15-$30, I don't know. But a beginner's primer, I would say, is Maybelline. I would say Maybelline, but just like with primer, always use a little, because with like drugstore primers, always use a little, because like some of them are really be like a thick consistency, and you'll like figure out what I mean, like once you like get it and actually like feel it for yourself and stuff like that. So when I start off with like setting sprays and stuff like that, I started off like just getting like e.l.f. e.l.f. brand, or just like a random Beauty Supply brand setting sprays. They worked for like, you know, a minute or so, but some, you can find like really good setting sprays and stuff at Walmart and stuff like that. But the setting spray I use right now is the Urban Decay D-Slick brand, and this is the makeup setting spray oil control one. So this is what it looks like. And so I really like this because I do feel like it really definitely controls my oily skin, because I really do have oily skin. And I feel like it definitely works. The combo with the professional primer and the Urban Decay definitely works really well together. So yeah, this is Urban. Now on to eyebrows. So, like the Ruby Kisses and like the little random brands of pencils and stuff like that you can get the beauty supply. I definitely recommend those, like the little micro pencils, way more than an actual like pencil, because like with the pencils that you can find and stuff like that, the beauty supply, those will make like your skin like make your eyebrows really oily throughout the day, that I've noticed when I was using it. But I can say with this, it also gives you like a natural a more natural outcome too with the micro pencils, to give you like creamy consistency once you put it on your eyebrow. And so then I went to, the more I progress with my eyebrows, I start using the Anastasia Beverly Hills eyebrow pomade. And so, look, there's nothing here. And so I use this like every now and then if I'm just looking for like a real makeup like beat base. But I really don't really use it that much anymore, because I don't know, I just be wanting my eyebrows to look like super like natural now. So what I use now is actually dark brown eyeshadow. Like literally, this is eyeshadow. Crazy, right? And so in my guide, my beginner's guide, I have one of the titles, I think it's like number 3. No, it's not like number 4. It should be like, yeah, number 4 for the backwards eyebrow. That will be showing how to do the backwards eyebrow, because not only did I use eyeshadow, but I put like, I do my eyebrows a certain way, but not the traditional way. That's all I'm gonna say. You're just gonna have to watch the video to see. But yes, so I actually use dark brown eyeshadow to do my eyebrows now, for like a really simple natural look. But if I am going for like a more beat based look, I would go with the pomade. So with lashes, y'all, literally go to the beauty supply. I buy lashes and stuff like that from like people or like different like Instagram boutiques and stuff like that, but like it's okay to like go to the beauty supply. I still like got beauty supply. Shoot, I got beauty supply lashes on right now, y'all. I swear to God, I do. And so yeah, like get your lashes from the beauty supply. Literally, y'all, like we do not discriminate. Like, y'all, this is the palettes I got. So y'all, for beginners eyeshadow, literally I used to just get like random eyeshadows and stuff like that from like everywhere, like, because everyone, this is a James Charles palette, because like everywhere got like eyeshadow. So I used to always get like random palettes and stuff from like everywhere. So like literally, like just for like beginners eyeshadow, just start off with anything. Like, you don't really have to have a name brand, but if you want me to recommend you one, I would definitely recommend Juvia's Palace. I want to call it a palace so bad. But Juvia's Place, yeah, Juvia's Place eyeshadows are all super pigmented and like just super gorgeous. Yes, I know it's gone. Don't talk about it. But yes, I definitely would recommend any Juvia's Place palette. For, oh, this is the 35T Morphe Brush Palette. Morphe Palettes. I also have the Morphe 35G palette. Looks like this. Oh, I love this palette. I always use like golds and browns in my eyeshadow. So like, yeah, definitely would recommend that if you're like more of a golds and burnt orange and stuff like that. If you're more like a natural nudes and browns and purples and stuff like that, I would recommend the 35O, I think. And Morphe, I love Morphe palettes because they also really good for pigmentation as well. I also have the Anastasia Beverly Hills Subculture palette. I rarely ever use it. Yes, y'all, something just fell. And that's why. But oh my god, I just gotta clean that up later. So for lip gloss, y'all, this is not everything. This is just the stuff I can fit on here. But for lip glosses and lipsticks, I start off with lipsticks like from the Beauty Supply and like Walmart and stuff like that. Oh, I love this red. Milani, don't sleep on Milani, y'all, okay? And just like different lip glosses and stuff like that. So I still get lip glosses from like any place. If it's cute and popping, I'm gonna put it on my lips, period. And so yeah, but a good name brand lip gloss, I would say Sephora's actual makeup brand, Anastasia Beverly Hills. I think I have, I don't know where it's at. Oh, y'all, my favorite is NYX. This is what I would recommend. NYX butter, what is it? Butter gloss, best ever in the whole entire world. And yes, highly 10 out of 10 recommend that. Best lip gloss ever. And so yes, y'all, that is like all of my makeup, I think. And so yes, like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for the rest of this video and my ultimate beginner's makeup guide. And my ultimate beginner's makeup guide. So yeah. Bye. Baby, baby, baby. Ooh, it's